Hello everyone. Well, I just got back from working on a Star Wars story, and even though it may not have been in the Brother Fresh Air The Force Awakens was last year, I still really enjoyed it. I mean, since Disney wants to make a whole slew of these spin-off films, and there's more confirmed to be on the slate for through 2020, with a lot more in development in the next few years. And this is definitely a good stepping stone for them to start on, since... And as I expected, it does a really good job bridging the gap between Revenge of the Sith and Have a New Hope, not only in the events to play in the film, but also in style and tone as well. Since Gareth Edwards was definitely a good person to direct this film, since the visual style and direction he brings about... It's definitely a good example of the two, and even though there's definitely some unique flashes as he gave the whole production, as well as the many people working with him, it's definitely so recognizable as a Star Wars film, and story details the titular Rogue One, the first members of the Rogue Squadron from the original trilogy, and their mission to steal Death Star plans against, as the seeds of rebellion are planted against the massive might of the Empire here, and I'm not going to go into too many specifics, especially not going to spoil too much. If you want to find out the exact sequence of events, by all means, go see the movie. A lot of you probably already planning to, just be my policy, honestly, ever since, I started doing these kind of reviews, if I had spoiled something, I'll post a warning in front of the video, give you enough time to click over something else on your computer or other device, And I could definitely say, that even someone who doesn't hate the prequels or even dislike them, it's an ideal... a way to bridge the gaps between both trilogies, as well as help train the connections between what the other films going to be working on, among the Rogue Squadron, are a snarky, but intelligent droid, known as K2SO, voiced by Alan Tudyk, who is more or less C-3PO's polar opposite, and basically... an ideal successor to Wash, my favorite show, Firefly. Got the whole series downloaded on my computer. Gonna be watching this, especially on Classcom, that's important right now. I don't know if Sweden potentially wanting to direct a spin-off film in the future. I think we could probably work out that way. Other members of note include a former soldiers in Clone War, such as Saw Gerrera, player Forrest Whitaker, as well as Baze Malbus. I know who plays him, just trying to remember his name, trying to do all that's supposed to relatively fresh my mind, as I often do whenever I see a new movie, a big one in the theater, And one of the ones stood out most is I thought of me, I totally called it, that Chirrut Imwe, played by Donnie Yen, a blind mystic who carries a torch of the Jedi Order, has much like Daredevil, Hevel and Toph from the Avatarverse, his remaining four senses, one of the Force are impeccable. It's not many people, not just in the Star Wars universe, but in any movie for that matter, who can actually, you could really believe that he can fight against impossible odds, even when fate had night and the ability to see. He's also liking how similar pattern to the Rebels TV show, which I also love, by the way. I'm kind of getting caught up on that on demand. And I'm not sure if the season's over, if it's just on break or what, but... I have been immensely appreciative of what Disney's been doing with the franchise. It's kind of warm in here, let me take this off, and... Well, because of how... Since now that I know how well I've been doing Marvel, and I'm probably going to do another vlog on the trailers because of how much content was in this film. Since they've managed to get on the same mindset as myself as a young man, getting the people involved that make a movie I want to see, or rather the creators here want to see as much as the fans were, like me. I mean, this lightsaber, if I have, has one of the ones I showed you in a previous video when I saw Phantom 3D a while ago. I was clipped to my belt during the whole showing. I mean, there weren't as many people in the theater, but there's still about 100 or so in there at least. I mean, so at $6 a head, that made the little venue I went to as low as $600 in that showing alone. Last night, as of this recording, since some theaters are anticipating demand nowadays, we're actually opening the shows when earliest from the clock. I mean, made $29 million, which was more than Batman vs. Superman, Captain America Civil War, or both of them. Which should be an indicator that even if won't make as much money as Force Awakens did, this, as well as the other spinoff films, are planning on going to definitely protect their investment for a very long time. I mean, even if the time comes, we'll have to one day give this whole thing up and look for work someplace else, and that time is coming. I mean, if I am just sitting in bed as an old man and watch one of these movies, and they're gonna keep making them as long as they keep making money, well, my opinion, just be okay. And I definitely think that Edwards, my paraphrase him, one of the behind the scenes videos released a while ago, leading up to this movie, he compared the experience like a young man playing with Star Wars toys in your backyard, and it's like you're given a bigger thing to work with in this grand scale, and I definitely agree. I mean, even though it may seem like a smaller film compared to a main entry in the series, I mean, it still managed to feel every bit as impressive on the scale they're working with, since it's like that boy grew up to be a man, they gave him a camera and a budget of $20 million to work with, and not only has very notable appearances from characters we all know and love. I mean, even if Vader only doesn't appear very long in the movie, when he does appear, it's quite impressive. That's what I mean. Even if I'd be wanting to go see a movie about his rise of power, this would be a good template to start with, in my opinion. Again, I'm not going to say what he does, just let's go see it, and you'll understand how I feel. I guarantee it. And the visuals for the money they've spent are quite impressive. Not just with all his impressive space battles, as well as the worlds inhabit, just even the sight I've seen in the Death Star itself is even as impressive as when I first saw New Hope when I was a young man and myself. So my perspective on the whole thing is an interesting one, since it's often said that your age often helps determine your experience in the saga, and I have to agree in that regard. I mean, because even if the films as a whole have varying degrees of quality, depending on who you ask, especially for me, there hasn't been a single one I've disliked so far, and this film definitely continues that trend. I feel the same way as I did when I went to go see Force Awakens last year, even if I don't feel exactly the same. I feel similarly, let's say that. Because you want to see these crazy car movie stars, this is where it happens. Depends where these talented young actors taking scope, making a mistake in the once my favorite film franchise ever. And also Orson Krennic, in many ways, he's even more evil than Grandma Turkin, and as well as his very, even when they figure out they managed to work with archive footage of the late Peter Cushing, as well as digitally recreate the actor, which is impressive effect, by the way, even if it invokes memories of Nexus's replicants and Blade Runner, more human than human, if you know what I'm saying. Because Tarkin, again, part of what makes him so vile is that he doesn't understand why others are horrified by what he does, as he sees it just like an order effect. Krennic, however, is driven by pure malice and spite in what he does, even with his own, even within the Empire, I mean. And as a final note, before I even have my verdict, that the film, despite being at its core a very grand and beautiful space opera, actually has pretty good insight on what on every conflict, and also shows some shades of gray, even among on the what voices you've seen do battle since you were young, I mean, since they are, I mean, even the aliens and droids are merely human qualities that I absolutely admire, whether I'm watching an independent production or a big budget blockbuster, I mean, that's so sense, and there are casualties on both sides, and the lines between good and evil are much more ambiguous in this film than other ones, I would suggest. I mean, I like the quality, I mean, since the whole way it's portrayed is simple enough for a child to understand, but yet complicated enough for someone like me and many others on this site to have discussions about it and what it means. And that's definitely, I think, the blockbuster we need in this day and age, especially given how heavy this year has been, how uncertain the future looks, I mean. And it's highly recommended in that case. So, I'm definitely seriously considering going again, but I'm going to be going to my grandfather this weekend, probably, I mean, depending on what happens. And I'm definitely going to have some kinds of small videos while the year is out. I'm also giving some time to think about another episode, but for now, I'm definitely going to enjoy this movie, and the prospect of more of the haze and the haze in the year is coming. I mean, Jesus, you know, Christmas present to us all as fans. So, I give this movie a strong 3.5 out of 4, and I definitely can close with a phrase, haze that has stuck in my head since I walked out of theater. I mean, I am the force with me. Bang.